50th birthday blessings for Jennifer Rose Pinto, birthday blessings for Joyce Rodericks, Fidelis Cabral, Renzel Rodericks, Karen Sarau, Abundance Globo, birthday remembrance for Margaret Baptista and Rudolph D'Souza, good health and recovery of Anna M. Dias, for the souls of Uvida Pereira, Anthony Acevedo, Willie, Berna and Justine Vesalker, Rosie Vesalker, Jermaine Dias and Archie Dias, Das Joseph, Tommy Alex and Santana Fernandez, Juliet Martis, Frederick, Maureen and Savio Albuquerque and Jude Fernandez, Joe Luis Gonsalves, Josephine and Charles Massey, Kenneth Fernandez. We also pray for all those who celebrate their birthdays and anniversaries today. All together, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the priceless communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, today the church celebrates the feast of Saint Irenaeus, Bishop and Martyr. Like Saint Irenaeus, let us pray that we may be totally dedicated to the cause of God in our lives. To celebrate the sacred mysteries of this Eucharist in a worthy manner, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord's pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
O God, who called the Bishop Saint Irenaeus to confirm true doctrine and the peace of the Church, grant, we pray, through his intercession, that being renewed in faith and charity, we may always be intent on fostering unity and concord. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. The men set out from Oaks of Mamre, and they looked down toward Sodom. And Abraham went with them to set them on their way. The Lord said, "Shall I hide from Abraham what I am about to do, seeing that Abraham shall surely become a great and mighty nation, and all the nations of the earth shall be blessed in him? For I have chosen him, that he may command his children and his household after him, to keep the way of the Lord, by doing righteousness and justice, so that the Lord may bring to Abraham what he has promised him. Then the Lord said, because the outcry against Sodom and Gomorrah is great, and their sin is very grave, I will go down to see whether they have done altogether according to the outcry that has come to me. And if not, I will know. So the men turned from there and went towards Sodom. But Abraham still stood before the Lord. Then Abraham drew near and said, will you indeed sweep away the righteous with the wicked? Suppose there are 50 righteous within the city. Will you then sweep away the place and not spare it for the 50 righteous who are in it? Far be it from you to do such a thing, to put the righteous to death with the wicked, so that the righteous fare as the wicked. Far be that from you. Shall not the judge of all the earth do what is just? And the Lord said, if I find at Sodom 50 righteous in the city, I will spare the whole place for their sake. Abraham answered and said, behold, I have undertaken to speak to the Lord, I who am but dust and ashes. Suppose five of the 50 righteous are lacking. Will you destroy the whole city for lack of five? And he said, I will not destroy it if I find 45 there. Again he spoke to him and said, suppose 40 are found there. He answered, for the sake of 40, I will not do it. Then he said, oh, let not the Lord be angry, and I will speak. Suppose 30 are found there. He answered, I will not do it if I find 30 there. He said, behold, I have undertaken to speak to the Lord. Suppose 20 are found there. He answered, for the sake of 20, I will not destroy it. Then he said, oh, let not the Lord be angry, and I will speak again but this once. Suppose 10 are found there. He answered, for the sake of 10, I will not destroy it. And the Lord went his way when he had finished speaking to Abraham, and Abraham returned to his place. The word of the Lord. Our response is, the Lord is compassionate and gracious. Kindly listen to the tune.
The Lord is compassionate and gracious.
All together.
The Lord is compassionate and gracious.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all within me his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and never forget all his benefits. All together.
The Lord is compassionate and gracious.
It is the Lord who forgives all your sins, who heals every one of your ills, who redeems your life from the grave, who crowns you with mercy and compassion. All together.
The Lord is compassionate.
Today, harden not your hearts, but listen to the voice of the Lord.
And a scribe came up and said to him, teacher, I will follow you wherever you go. And Jesus said to him, Foxes have holes, and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Another of the disciples said to him, Lord, let me first go and bury my father. And Jesus said to him, Follow me, and leave the dead to bury their own dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Dear brothers and sisters, one of the most beautiful stories in the book of Genesis is Abraham pleading before God on behalf of the cities, the people of Sodom and Gomorrah. Abraham is testing God's patience, and God is extremely benevolent till the end of time. Abraham is constantly negotiating for righteous people to be found in Sodom and Gomorrah so that these two cities are saved from punishment. My dear friends, the negotiation which started between Abraham and God finally seeks its completion in the New Testament, because Jesus is the one, the righteous one, in whom we are saved. Even though we are all sinners, Jesus is the Lamb who takes away the sins of the world. Jesus saves us. Jesus is our salvation. In Jesus we find our liberation. Today the church celebrates the feast of Saint Irenaeus, bishop and martyr. He is a Greek bishop, and he practiced his ministry in the Diocese of Lyons in France. As a bishop, he was extremely passionate, zealous of the apostolic teaching of the church, and he preached vehemently against all the heresies, and very specially the heresy of Gnosticism. Abraham and Irenaeus, they were in both intimate relationship with the Lord. At this Eucharist, my dear friends, with the words of the Gospel, in the words of the Gospel, the Son of Man has no place to lay his head. At the same time, the Son of Man also looks for people who are totally committed and zealous. Let us pray that we may serve the Son of Man with an undivided attention, that we may give Jesus the first place and the best place in our lives. Amen.
At this time of giving, loudly now we pray, gifts that have been given by our God and King. Here is our bread of faith, work of human hands. This is the bread of joy. We will share in love at this time of giving. Gladly now we pray, gifts that have been given by our God and King. See, Lord, this joy is wine, harvested from us. This is our wine of love, ready for the feast.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
May the sacrifice we offer you with joy on the heavenly birthday of Saint Irenaeus bring you glory, O Lord, and instill in us a love of the truth, so that we may keep the Church's faith inviolate and her unity secure, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
He is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you are glorified when your saints are praised. Their very sufferings are but wonders of your might. In your mercy you give ardor to their faith, to their endurance you grant firm resolve, and in their struggle the victory is yours through Christ our Lord. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we with all the host of angels cry out, and without end we acclaim. That they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Oswald Gracious, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power, the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus,
I believe
that you are present.
In the most holy sacrament.
I love you above all things. And I desire
to receive you
into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment
receive you sacramentally.
Come at least spiritually. Into my heart.
I embrace you.
As if you were already there. And unite myself.
Holy to you.
Never permit me.
To be separated from you.
Amen.
Walk with me, O my Lord, through the darkest night and brightest day. Be at my side, O Lord, hold my hand and guide me on my way. Sometimes the road seems long, my energy is spent. Then, Lord, I think of you and I am given strength. Walk with me, O my Lord, through the darkest night and brightest day.
For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba Father, have mercy on us, save us from the virus. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba, Father, have mercy on us. Save us from the virus. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba, Father, have mercy on us. Save us from the virus. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba, Father, have mercy on us. Save us from the virus. For the sake of Jesus' most sorrowful passion, Abba, Father, have mercy on us. Save us from the virus. Through these sacred mysteries we pray, O Lord, give us in your compassion an increase of that faith which brought glory to the Bishop Saint Irenaeus as he maintained it even until death, and may the same faith bring to us who truly follow it justification in your sight, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners,
now
and in the hour of our death. Amen. Our Lady of Mount Carmel,
pray for us. To follow the Lord and find freedom, to love as He loved and bring peace, to spend all our life for His sake.